force requirement in the case of sheet metal work. So we have a punch of diameter equals to D, and we have a plate of thickness equals to T, and we have a die here, which is supported here. So we have a penetration here. So the final part will come out like this. So this area is get sheared or get blank. So this one is shear area. For this particular case, it is equals to pi multiplied by T multiplied by T. Now this time no shear is provided. So we require maximum force. So maximum force is given by the pi dt multiplied by. Now when the punch is moved downward, it is partly penetrated up to this length only. That is called as percentage of penetration. It is usually expressed in percentage of T. So punch is not penetrated fully, it is penetrated only P times T. So this distance traveled will be P multiplied by T, where P is called as percentage of penetration. If you assume the ideal condition, then the force required for this one, the maximum force, and during this one, we have a punch travel equal to P multiplied by T. So area under this graph is called as work done, or is also called as energy. So energy is given by F max into P multiplied by T. P is usually for 10%, 50%, whatever it may be, depends upon the material. It is 1/3 for MS and full penetration for soft materials. The right side figure represents the shear on one side. So in this case, your penetration length will remain same. So this distance is same as P multiplied by T. But the punch has to travel the additional distance equals to what? S plus P plus T. Because of this one, your energy remains same. So you will get a diagram like this. So this is the extra distance covered, that equal to shear. Since the area under this graph is same as area under this graph, so this one is the one force required for shear. So force required for shear using same energy concept is Fs multiplied by P into T plus shear S. Energy required for both cases are same, so we equate 1 and 2. In that case, we get Fmax. Fmax multiplied by P multiplied by T is same as Fs into P multiplied by T plus the shear length, that equals to S. So from this, we can calculate the shear force, which is equals to Fmax P into T from P into T plus S. So naturally, this is fraction, so Fs is less than Fmax. So we require less force while we are doing the shearing. If the shear provided is very very large as compared to penetration multiplied by thickness, in that case P plus into T plus S is approximately equals to S. Suppose P into T, penetration into T is a small value as compared to S value, so it is approximately equal to S. In that case Fs will be equals to Fmax multiplied by P multiplied by T divided by S. We can use this formula for quick calculation. Okay, if you enlarge this figure, the vertical dimension is S and D is the diameter of the punch, and this value will be equals to what? Theta. Theta is called as shear angle. We can calculate theta as tan inverse upon opposite upon adjacent, S by D. So theta is called shear angle. Let's consider a washer. The inner diameter of washer is DI, outer diameter of washer is D0. It has a small thickness. So we can prepare this washer in two stages. First stage is that we have a blank like this, and first we have a punch. So using punch, we can make the inner dimension first, and then we have a, now this time we have to use the same plate. This part is pierced out, so there is a hole here now. This plate has inner hole now. Now the same plate is again kept on the second stage with the already hole at center, and now we have the second punch of this size. So it will penetrate this much portion. And what you get a final part is like this. So entire arrangement you can keep on one single die. That is called as staggered arrangement. Staggered. So first is we are making the inner hole and then we are making the outer hole. It's only operation we are performing. So how much is cut length for the first part? For this stage, what is the force required? For this, force required is pi multiplied by di multiplied by t multiplied by what? Tau. So is there force required in first stage? How much is force required in second stage? Is F2. Is pi multiplied by du multiplied by tau. So out of this, which value is more value? This value. So naturally, you have to select the capacity of the machine equal to this value. So maximum value will be equals to what? Your capacity of press. So here this one is called as capacity. Capacity is based on what? Maximum value. Not on minimum value. This one is minimum value. This one is maximum value. This one is called as staggered arrangement. First operation done, then second operation done. This one is called as compound die. In this one, this punch is used to make the inner hole, and these two punches, which are round in shape, are used to make the outer hole. So this one is also punch. This one is die. This one is our plate. This one is stripper plate, and it will return back by using the spring. So you can imagine this one is hollow portion. Now, this entire operation of the washer is done in single stage. Here, the entire operation is done in two stages. First, this stage and then second this stage. So, when we are doing the both operations simultaneously, you can imagine this. So, first of all, this will get punched. Can you shake it? Now, the center point is, punch is not in touch. Now, it will get pressed. So, outer diameter is cut. Now, it is again progresses. And now the second punch is made and then it will return back to the original position. And then the plate is again moved to the next position. These are called as grippers. So this portion is called as gripper. In compound die, we are performing two or more operations simultaneously. This type of die is called as progressive die. This one is called as progressive die. So the operations are done in progression. That is why it is called as progressive die. Number of this punch is also called as cutting die. They do the cutting operation and these do the punching operation. Now, since both the operations are done simultaneously, total force required will be equals to F1 plus F2. F1 is for inner and F2 is for outer. So, we have total length equal to pi is di plus d0. That is common from both. Multiplied by thickness is common, multiplied by tau. So, this much force is required for compound die. Naturally, capacity of compound die is much large as compared to our progressive die. And if you provide the shear to this, actually shear provided is very large. So we can find out Fs. Then is this quantity is max quantity? So Fs will be equals to F max P multiplied by T divided by S. Assuming that S is more than what? P into T. For quick calculation, you can use this. This one is called as cutoff die. This one is called as punch. This one is called as die. This one is the, which is holding it, is called as punch steel. One which is holding it is called as die steel. Now this plate is inserted between the cutting die like this. Can you imagine this? So when it inserted, it will look like this in the front view. And therefore, you get a cutting at this point. So cutting you can get at this point. So this plane will be get shear. It is clear. Only you can see the front view. This one is thickness. So this one is thickness. This one is width. So this one is shear plane. What is the area of shear plane now? Simply V multiplied by T. So what is the force required? So maximum force required will be, that will be equal to B multiplied by T multiplied by tau. That is required for one stroke. Likewise, we can make a part of this. First part, then we make the second part, then we'll make the third part. Like, so long piece, long sheet can be cut into small parts as per the requirement. Yesterday we have seen the video on this. Now this time, I am showing you the plane. That is this plane. Is this plane is same as this plane. And this time, the length of this portion, that is this portion, you can visualize here. Now this time, is the width of this portion is more than the plate width. So you can very well cut it, no problem. Suppose this width is 200, that is your shear width, and you can cut 100 mm very easily. So what is the maximum width you can cut? 200 mm. Now I have shown your flat end. Is it with shear or without shear? This is without shear. So whether the width of your punch is matter or the width of the plate is matter. Punch of the width of the punch matters or the, for this one, what is B? Is it the width of plate, not of punch? So B is width of plate. If B1 is the width of the punch, then is B is less than equals to B1. That is maximum permissible. That is this length can be equal to what? 200. But cannot be more than 200. Otherwise, cutting is not possible. If I provide the shear, I can provide the shear on this blade. That is this area. And my shear plane is like this. So this height is called as shear. So that shear, you can visualize in this figure, is like this. So this small length is this shear. But the effective shear for this one is only this portion. Is it effective shear? Effective shear is this only. So I will call this one is S1. So S is what? Total shear. Then what is S1? S1 is called as effective shear. So when the idea of effective shear comes, when your B is less than B1, if B is less than, that is this value of B is less than B1, then the idea of this will come. Now let enlarge this figure first. Here. So this one is total shear and this length equal to what? B1. But your actual plate is less than B1, only this portion. So is this one will be called as effective shear. This one is plate. So can we calculate the value of S1 from similar triangles? So what is effective shear? So effective shear S1 will be S1 divided by S is same as B divided by B1. Agree? So your effective shear will come as S1 multiplied by S multiplied by width of the plate divided by B1, the width of the punch. So if the effective shear is less than the actual shear provided. Say for example, our width is B is equal to what? 100. And the width of the punch is what? 200. And suppose I make a shear equals to what? 20 mm. So now will I get the advantage of 20 mm? Or I have to calculate this? I have to calculate this value. So actual shear will be 220 multiplied by 100 divided by 200. So actual shear is only 10 mm. And therefore, my Fs will be equals to what? Fmax multiplied by P. What is P? Retraction. Multiplied by T. Thickness. Divided by. Is it S or is it S1 now? S1. So normally student will make a mistake here. They directly take value of S. But S is not effective. Because the width of the plate is less than the width of the punch. Estimate the blanking force to cut a blank of 25 mm wide and 30 mm long. So we have given a blank here. The width of this one is 25 and is 30 mm long. And the thickness of the stock is 1.5 mm. And if the ultimate shear strength of this is given as 450. So tau is given as 450 megapascal. Also determine the work done if the percentage penetration is 25%. So percentage of penetration is 0.25. So you want to do the cutting over this entire line. So it's 25 plus 30 plus 25 plus 30. So that is the pelvis cutting length. It is 25 this side plus 30. Is this side multiplied by 2 times. Is 55 multiplied by 2, 110. So if you take the product of this, you can calculate maximum force. That is the cutting length multiplied by T multiplied by tau. 110 to 1.5 into 450. 74.25 kilonewton. So whatever the force you are getting here, that is 74.25 multiplied by kilo is 1000. And if you divide this number by 9.81, that is kg. So what is this number come? He said that this press has a capacity of 7.56 tons. So next time, if I give the capacity of ton, can you calculate the force available? So 7.56 ton for 1000 multiplied by 9.81, your answer is 74.2. So they can ask you either the force in this fashion or they can ask you the force in terms of, that is called as capacity of press. Second part, you want to calculate work done. So work done is given by the maximum force multiplied by the punch travel. Punch travel is given by P multiplied by T. We will divide this quantity by 1000. Convert mm into meters. So we have 74.25, 10 to the power 3, that is Newton. Penetration was given as 0.25. Thickness was given as 1.5 divided by 1000. 27.84 is Newton meter. In a blanking operation to produce a steel washer, the maximum punch load is 2 into 10 to the power 5. So Fmax is given to us. 2 into 10 to the power 5. The plate thickness is 4 mm and the percentage penetration is 25, 0.25. You want to calculate just the work done during this shearing operation. So work done equals to Fmax multiplied by punch travel. That is P multiplied by T. Just put this value and find out this. Take care that it should be divided by what? 1000. You should get 200 Newton per meter. A rectangular slot of 100 by 50 mm. So we have a rectangular slot of 100 by 50 mm. It's to be made for 5 mm thick plate. Having a ultimate shear, ultimate tensile strength and which one is useful for us? Only shear strength is 300 megapascal. The hole is made by punching process. Neglecting the effect of clearance, you want to find out punching force. Straightforward question. We have Fmax is a total length cut multiplied by T multiplied by tau. Total length cut is 100 plus 150 plus 150. 300, 450. Is it kilonewton? So this dimension is D, the perimeter will be equals to what? Pi D. So your force will be equals to, perimeter is pi D multiplied by T multiplied by tau. Diameter is 100, 1.5, tau is 300, very close to 141.4 kilonewton. For a punching, a 10 mm circular hole. So we have a punching operation and diameter of the hole we want to make equals to what? 10 mm. This we want to make a punch. So we have a punching operation and then we want to make a rectangular blank of size equals to 50 by 20 mm. 50 by 200 mm. So we have a blanking operation this time. Tau is given to us is 240. You want to calculate the size of the punch for this case. You want to calculate the size for this case. So are we able to calculate the clearance first? Recall the formula for clearance. Is it 0.0032 times T under root of tau? So this one is 0.0032. How much is thickness? 1 mm and under root of 240. 0.049. I will make it very close to 0.05.
Is that fine?
Very close value. For quick calculation, we will dismiss. Now, first of all, when you are doing the punch, so is the diameter of punch is same as the diameter of hole size, that equal to what? 10 mm. And the diameter of die is the diameter of punch plus 2 times radial clearance. So this one is 10 plus 2 times of 0.05. So this is 10.1 mm. For the blank operation, then we required a blank size. Now this time we have a square blank. So we write the size of die is same as the size of blank. So this one is same as 200 by 50. For this one, if you want to design the punch, we'll find out width of punch. So width of punch equals to 50. That is this size of blank, 50 minus 2 times the radial clearance, minus 2 times clearance on both sides. So 50 minus 0.05, 39.9. Secondly, we want we will say the length of this. Actually, length is wrong, but we have to say the length of. So the other dimension of the punch is 200 minus 26. So 200 minus 0.1, 199. So this is how we can define for the size of the punch and die for both operations. Finally, we require to calculate the force in both cases. So force required for this case is perimeter of this one. That is the maximum force. So perimeter is pi d multiplied by t divided by tau. Diameter is 10, plate thickness is 1, tau is 240, 7.5 kN. And for the blanking, you required a force equals to the perimeter of this one is 2 times 200 plus 50 into thickness. Thickness equals to what? 1 into tau is equal to 240, 120 kN. The force requirement in a blanking operation of a low carbon steel sheet is 5 kN. The thickness of the sheet uses T. So initial thickness was T1 equals to T. And the diameter of the blank part is D. So diameter of blank part is D1 equals to D. So value of F1 is basically equals to pi into D multiplied by thickness T. That is pi D1 multiplied by. For the same work material, if the diameter is increased to what? 1.5D. So second time, he says that the diameter was increased to 1.5D. And the thickness is reduced to 0.4D. So thickness was reduced to 2 is final value. So this one is 0.40. So you want to find out the F2 value. So naturally F2 will be equals to what? Pi times D2 multiplied by T2. We have forget to write tau here and tau. So we can write this value as pi into 1.5D. T2 is 0.40 into tau. So 1.5 into 0.4. Is it 0.6? Best term is pi D tau. Now what is pi D tau? Is 5 kN. So your answer is 0.6 multiplied by 5. So your answer is 3 kN. With a punch for which the maximum crushing stress is 4 times of what? Maximum shearing stress. We have sigma cr equal to 4 times of tau. The biggest hole that can be punched in the plate would be the diameter equal to, out of this you have to select the value. So all this we have to go for what? Shear strength equal to what? Crushing strength. So shear area will be pi t multiplied by t multiplied by tau. And what is the crushing? Crushing is pi by 4. Into d square into sigma crush. So cancel out common terms. Pi will cancel, one of the d will cancel, and you can replace sigma cr equals to what? 4 times tau. So we have t equal to t multiplied by tau, and on the right hand side we have 1 by 4 this d as it is, and sigma cr is replaced by 4 times tau. So this 4 and 4 cancel, tau and tau cancel. So is t is same as, so the choice b is correct. On this objective question, in the sheet metal blanking process, shear is provided on punches and dies. For what purpose? To reduce the press load. A 10 mm diameter holes are to be punched in a sheet of 3 mm thickness. So we have diameter equals to 10 mm. Thickness of the plate equals to 3 mm. Shear strength of the material is how? Is 400 MPa. Penetration percentage is 40%, 0.4. Here provided on the punch is 2 mm. We want to calculate the blanking force. We want to calculate blanking force, which shear. So are we interested in Fs value? So initially we will find out maximum force. So maximum force is given by, so in circular blank, we have pi multiplied by d, multiplied by t, multiplied by tau. Pi, diameter is 10, thickness is 3 mm, this one is 400, 37.69. Is it kilonewton? Now we have second formula for energy. Energy is what? F max multiplied by P multiplied by T equal to Fs multiplied by, the punch travel is P multiplied by T plus S. Since the choice is known to us, we have to check out which answer will come. F max is 37.69. Penetration is 0.4. Thickness is 3 mm. Fs we have to find out. Penetration is 0.4. into 3. How much is shear? Shear is 2. Your answer come out to be 14.3. But this answer is not listed here. whenever you are not getting your answer here, assumption, that is the value of P by T is equal to what? 0 with respect to S. And let's try for it again. So we have 37.69 into 0.4 into 3 into FS. Only shear will be considered. We are assuming S is very, very greater than P multiplied by T. Now check your value of FS. 22.6 means expected, he is expecting that we should consider this. But for a 50% penetration of work material, a punch with a single shear equal to thickness will reduce the punch load to the half the value, maintain the same punch load, will increase the punch load by half the value and reduce the punch load to the quarter load. We have to prove this. 50% penetration of work material and the shear is equals to what? Thickness. So we have S equals to what? T. And what is the value of P multiplied by T? If this value is 0.5, so what is Fs? Fs equals to Fmax multiplied by P multiplied by T divided by S. We are assuming this. What we are assuming? S is very, very greater than P multiplied by T. Is 0.5 times T divided by T. So is your load is reduced by 50%. So your load is reduced to half the value. A hole of 100 mm diameter is to be punched in a steel plate 5.6 mm thick. The ultimate shear stress is 550 MPa. With the normal clearance of the tool, the cutting is complete at 40% penetration of the punch. Use suitable shear angle. You want to find out shear angle for the punch to bring the work within the capacity of 30 ton capacity. So we want Fs to bring the work within the capacity of 30 ton. We have Fs equals to what? 30 ton. Ton is 1000 multiplied by 9.81. 294.3. If this answer is kilonewton, we can also find out Fmax. Fmax is simply pi multiplied by d, that is the perimeter, multiplied by t multiplied by tau. Diameter is 100 mm, thickness is 5.6 mm, tau is 550. We can get Fmax 968 kilonewton. Can we calculate capacity at this instant? We can very well calculate capacity. This one is 968 divided by 9.81. Directly coming to what? Tons. So very close to 100. 98.67. So if you do not provide shear, you require capacity equal to what? 98 points. But if you want to, you have to give the proper shear so that it will reduce to load equal to what? 30. So this time again I assume S is very, very greater than P multiplied by, so Fs is Fmax P multiplied by T divided by S. Fs is known to us, 294.3. This one is kilonewton. So this value also put in kilonewton. Penetration was given as 0.4. Thickness was given as 5.6. So shear come out to be 7.36. So this one is called as shear angle. This is S and D. So what is the value of tan theta? S divided by punch diameter, 7.36. Diameter of punch is same as the diameter of hole. That is 100, 4.2 degrees. A washer has a 12.7 mm hole. So let's say DI. Inside diameter is 12.7 mm. Outside diameter is 25.4 mm. And thickness is 1.25 mm. It is made up of SA1020 steel having shear strength of 280 MPa. We have to find out three different cases. Find the total cutting force if both the punches, act at the same time and no shear is provided. So this time, if both the punches will act at the same time, if the cutting length will be inside perimeter plus outside perimeter, and that will be max value because no shear is provided. So for part 1, total cutting force is Fmax is pi, inner perimeter is pi di, outer perimeter is pi do, multiplied by thickness t multiplied by tau. Just put this value here and find out this one. I think you should get 41.89 kilonewton. Is with shear or without shear? This one is without shear. Is the compound die or progressive die? This one is compound die. What will be the cutting force if the punches are staggered so that only one punch acts at a time? Naturally, when the punches are in staggered position, the outer perimeter is larger value. So we have to use for case B. Fmax is decided on the basis of pi do only, because pi di will be smaller quantity. So maximum force is decided by pi di multiplied by t multiplied by tau. Again, put this value and get your answer. 27 point. Why I am selecting this one? Because if I able to calculate for inside, let's say inside, it will be pi multiplied by di divided by t multiplied by tau. How much this comes? So will you employ this capacity of press or will you employ 27.9 capacity of press? We should use 27.9. So value is decided in progressive on maximum value, not on minimum value. In third case, assume 60% penetration for steel and shear provided is 1 mm, and the force needed if both the punches act together. So you have to use this one. This answer is a maximum force when both the punches are used. So using this data, we can calculate the Fs. So we have Fs equal to F max. Let's call this one is dash value for part is P multiplied by T divided by S. So F max, we are using the A value, which is for both. So F max is 41.89. Penetration was given to you as 60% multiplied by thickness is 1.25 and value of S shear prodded is 1 mm, 31.4 kN. In a shear cutting operation, a sheet of 5 mm thickness, so we have thickness equals to 5 mm, is cut along a length of 200 mm. So what is the width of the cut you want to make? 200 mm. The cutting blade is 400 mm. So I think we have labeled it as B1. The cutting edge, so we have labeled as B1. So B1 equals to 400 mm. And the zero shear, initially no shear is provided. So initially shear is zero. The ultimate shear strength is 100. So we have tau equals to 100 megapascal. And the penetration is, penetration to thickness ratio is given this time. So penetration to thickness ratio is 0.2. So what is the value of P multiplied by T? Is 0.2 multiplied by T. T is how much? 5. How much is penetration? 1 mm? 1 mm. So in this figure he has given this one. Is this value is B1? This value is B1. And your plate is only 200 mm. So this one is plate size. A is 200. This one is the plate. This one is B1. And this one is, assuming the force versus displacement called to be rectangular. That we have already assumed. You want to find out work done. So first of all, we'll find out max force. So what is the maximum force? Your cutting is done only on these edges. Is it correct? And what is the width at this point? So this one is thickness 200. We want to cut only 200. Our blade is 400, but the cut is only for 200. Multiplied by thickness, multiplied by tau. Put T equal to 5, tau is equal to 100. So your answer is 100 kN. But we are interested in what? Work done. So we have work done. So work done is simply equals to F max multiplied by punch travel. Punch travel is what? 1 mm. That is P into T. So 100 and this one 100. Your answer is what? You want joules? You want joules. So this one is 100 10 to the power 3. That is Newton. This one is Newton. And P into T we have given in mm. So this one is multiplied by 10 to the power minus 3. Is it meter? This one is meter. This one is Newton. Your answer is 100 joules. So choice A is correct. A shear of 20 mm, S equal to 20 mm. So he has given this value equal to what? 20 mm. Is it an effective shear or this one is effective shear? Effective shear is S1. So we have a similar triangle here. So we have S1, that is effective shear over the plate width equal to 200. Total shear is 20 over the length of 400. So S1 will come out to be, that is effective shear is only 10 mm. Now this time is provided assuming the force versus displacement called to be trapezoidal. The maximum force in kilonewton exerted is. Now you want to find out force with what? Shear. Now this time force available, without shear is available? Without shear is available. So we have force with shear equal to F max multiplied by P multiplied by T divided by S or divided by S1. Now this time the assumption that we are making S1 very very greater than P into T is correct assumption. Why so? P into T is what? 1 mm. Only for this problem, this is correct value. 10 mm is much large as compared to what? 1 mm. So just put it this one. F max is 100. This one is 1 divided by 10. Your answer is 10 kN.